Welcome back to Babes in the Woods, an original comedic mystery adventure on Paris Underground Radio. In last week's episode, curiosity prevailed over logic. But when a wrong turn leads to a disastrous situation, how can Joanne and Britt find their way back to the path? The terrain our intrepid explorers find themselves in does nothing to calm their nerves, nor does an unexpected discovery. And now, episode 2, The Accident. So, are we following this arrow or not? Okay, nerd alert. What's that thing?
This is a compass, urbanite. I'm going to take a reading so we know where we are and how to get back. Okay, so it looks like the arrow points east. Maybe it leads to a mine or something.
Ooh, maybe we can find some gold.
Fool's gold for a fool.
How dare you?
Just kidding. You really want to follow it?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, but just like 5 minutes. As long as we stay due east, we'll easily find our way back.
Who do you think painted that arrow anyway? An Apache? A gnome? Bigfoot?
You know, there is a legend about these mountains. Some people say that there was a prospector who came through here in the 1870s and found a vein of gold and was digging it up when he heard a bunch of riders approaching on horseback. So he buried his gold as quickly as he could and tried to cover up the vein. He was ambushed and murdered, but the people never found the gold. So the legend is that now he haunts this trail looking for his buried gold.
Ooh, spooky. Do you think there really is gold around here?
Maybe. I think most of it's probably already been found.
Well, that's okay. I like the legend of Bigfoot better anyway.
Well, you never know. Okay, I think that's probably far enough.
But we haven't found what the arrow was pointing to.
It probably wasn't pointing to anything.
Spoil sport.
I'm not trying to be a spoil sport, but there's not actually a path here and the brush is getting thicker.
But doesn't it look like there's a clearing up ahead?
Maybe? Either way, we should head back.
Just one more.
Ah! Joanne, help! I'm falling!
Wait, take my hand!
Help!
Oh, no! Shit.
Oh, I'm sorry. My foot just slipped.
It's okay. It's not your fault.
So, now what do we do? Oh, my poor dress.
Well, we have to climb back up. It must be, what, 30 feet?
Climb back up?
We have to get back to the trail. Come on. There aren't any footholds.
I don't think we're going to get back up.
No, I don't either.
So, what do we do now?
Well, west is this way. Let's head back west and see if there's a better place to scramble back up.
I can't get up those rocks.
That's okay. We'll just walk around these boulders and head west.
We'll be right back with Babes in the Woods after a word from our sponsors.
To flâne is far more than to wander, and bonjour means way more than hello. Discover these and more words that teach us what makes the French so French with Navigating the French. Sundays on Paris Underground Radio.
What bra are you wearing right now? Whether you're smiling from ear to ear because you love your bra, or whether you winced because you're wearing, yet again, something you'd rather not, tune into Paris Undressed, the podcast that goes behind the seams of the lingerie capital of the world. Hi, I'm Kate Kemp Griffin, author and host of Paris Undressed. From boudoir to the street, we'll explore the art of making and wearing French lingerie, We'll meet the designers and brands shaping our bodies and talk to fascinating people about femininity, sensuality, and sexuality. We'll share bra stories, secrets, desires, hopes, and dreams. This is the ultimate special occasion. So put on your favorite bra and tune into Paris Undressed, Tuesdays on Paris Underground Radio.
And now, back to Babes in the Woods. Oh my God, what was that? Was that the prospector?
That whistle? That was a marmot.
A marmot?
Yeah, they look kind of like cute, fluffy prairie dogs. They're also called whistle pigs.
I'm going to use that the next time I'm at a construction site.
They live in the rocks and they whistle to warn the other marmots that there are predators around. They sleep like 8 or 9 months a year.
How do you know all this?
Well, you know the outdoor sporting goods store I work at?
Yeah.
Well, when it's slow, I read the guidebooks and the survival guides and trail guides and things like that. And then we sometimes have guest lecturers come in and give little talks.
Like book readings?
Kind of. They're usually more survival-based. Edible plant experts, how to make shelters, first aid, stuff like that.
Cool.
I learned how to make a tourniquet out of a condom.
Wow, that's quite the party trick.
What about you? How's your job going?
Good, good. I'm a junior account executive now, which is pretty fun. I'm assisting with a bunch of pretty cool PR campaigns. And I have my first presentation on Friday.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
Yeah. I mean, I won't be alone. My manager will be there in case I screw everything up. But it's my first shot at proving I can be somebody.
I don't understand your job at all.
I help people become famous, and famous people become even more famous.
Anyone I know?
Well, I can't name names, confidentiality and all that, but I did recently work on a campaign for a big actor.
You really can't tell me? I won't say anything, and there's no one else to hear us but the moose and the marmots.
Let's just say he worked on a little film called Ishin Mimpossible.
I couldn't possibly guess.
Oh my God, is that a cross?
Where?
That thing there poking out of the ground.
Oh, yeah. That must be a grave.
Out here? We're in the middle of nowhere.
That's what it looks like.
There's something written on it. Barlow. What did you say the prospector's name was?
I don't think I know his name. Could have been Barlow. Let me take a picture.
What was that?
Probably the prospector.
No, seriously.
Okay, no need to panic. That sounded like thunder, so we should just maybe move a little faster. Once we just get back to the trail, we'll be fine.
Is it getting darker?
Come on.
Doesn't this seem bigger to you?
This doesn't make sense. This should be a stream, not a river.
Are you sure we went the right way?
According to the compass, this is due west.
So what do we do?
I think we just need to find a way across. Look, over there. We can use those rocks.
This is crazy.
Don't be silly. Just follow me. And be careful. Step here. One more.
Oh, ah! I'm slipping! Oh, no!
Ouch!
Ow, my ankle!
The compass! You and your stupid sandals. You made me drop the compass.
Dun, dun, dun. Stay tuned for episode 3, Lost in the Woods. Thank you for listening to Babes in the Woods. Babes in the Woods is written by Barbara M. Betus and Jennifer Fox Garrity. The part of Joanne is played by Sion Dason. The part of Britt is played by Jennifer Fox Garrity. Our theme music is Despite the Traffic by Wes Hutchinson. Babes in the Woods is edited by Jennifer Fox Garrity and produced by Paris Underground Radio. If you like our show, please subscribe rate, review, and tell your friends. It really helps. For more on this show and shows like it, please go to parisundergroundradio.com. Thank you for listening.